A little clip before this chat right here. Am I supposed to turn here? Yeah. You know what? I'm just gonna chit chat with you guys in a bit when I park, or maybe after my spray tan, because I just got here and I did not calculate how short of a drive this was going to be. Okay, so I don't know if you can hear me, but I'm drying right now. Try not to show myself because I'm naked. This is weird. Can you see me? Am I dark? You know what? You can't even see my. Oh, you probably can still see my acne. I feel so sticky, but she said it's totally normal. My neck, though, my neck looks. Like, I'm fat on my neck, but you can really see it with the tan right here. Oh, it looks disgusting. It was really quick. It was like 15 minutes. That's how long it took. I was pretty surprised. I mean, it was my first time. I didn't want to, of course, I'm not gonna, you know, show the whole entire experience because I'm like half naked there. Apparently, you can be fully nude or topless. Or you could just have your underwear or a bikini set on. I decided to go topless because this is a trial run. I have my bridals on Monday, and the way my dress is, I needed to be topless. I couldn't afford to have any tan lines on. I speak a lot with my hands, I'm sorry about that. The spray tan itself lasted about like 15 minutes. It was pretty quick. She told me, you know, she just gave me all the instructions. As far as drying, It took about maybe another 15, 20 minutes. It's really all on your preference. I could have stood there for like 30 minutes if I wanted to, but I was already dry. She said you were gonna be sticky regardless after drying. I do feel sticky, but I am dried, so that's good. My only concern is my fingers because I kept touching myself and I feel like I'm gonna get orange. I don't know if you could see it, how pale I am here and then a little bit color here. We'll see. She did put lotion on my palms though, so when she spray tanned me, that it none would get on my palms. That I feel like after I dried myself, I feel like I got some color on it. So I'm gonna keep an eye out for that. But I got the 8-hour setting, whatever. I don't know what they call it, but I'm basically going to take a shower in 8 hours from now, which would be 6 p.m. I cannot exfoliate, use any oils, or I can't use the loofah when I'm showering, any soap. I just have to rinse my body off with cold water, and that's it. She says apparently I would get darker. I feel like this color is good enough, so I'm kind of scared how darker it's going to get. I don't know, it's like freaking me out. I'll see if I can even insert a photo, like a little small preview of like my tan line on my underwear. Okay, so it's back to the wedding talk. We finished our backdrops. I was saying before, me and Carlos went to Home Goods and Marshall's and to buy some dessert trays because we're going to use that for our dessert ladders that I previously vlogged of my dad and him making for the wedding. Today we're actually going to go get our marriage license too, and then tomorrow I'm picking up my wedding dress. It's my final fitting, and then I'm going to, you know, have our bridals on Monday, and I'm excited. So yeah, all right, well, I'm on my way home, and before I get lost, I'm just going to go ahead and end this clip here, and you would see us the next time. Oh my god, there's a lot of trash on the ground. Alright, so the next time you see me, it will be a clip of us maybe at court filling out our license, our marriage license.
It's okay, man. I'll buy you a Starbucks right now. Oh, I like these lids.
Yeah, I like them too. But that's the reason why I can't have the pumpkin cold brew anymore. Excuse the hot mess. Y'all already know that I just came back from a spray tan. This is weird talking to my camera in front of Carlos. Okay. You just got a marriage license! It is real! I can't show the bottom right because my address is on there. 25 more days, babe. 25 more days. Okay, so as you guys just seen, we just picked up our marriage license. I texted my mom. She was freaking out. She actually thought we got married. I told her no, it was just basically the certificate, like just a permission. Our officiant has to officially sign it at the day of the wedding to make it official. So she was like, okay. She's like, I was so mad. I thought you guys got married at court. I wasn't there. It was funny. Anyway, okay, so we just got home. There's nothing else to do for the rest of the day. Tonight, I am going to my girlfriend's house because we're going to start talking about my bachelorette and see what we're going to be doing. My bachelorette is in 2 weeks. We're going to do it on the weekend before Christmas, which will be Saturday the 21st. But we're going to discuss what we're going to do because I have no idea. But real quickly, I'm just going to show you how much of a mess my living room looks right now for the wedding. So this is how the living room is looking right now. This is the shelves that my father and Carlos made. We painted it white. I'm not sure if I ever showed the final touch. Ignore my Christmas tree. This is basically the only Christmas decoration in this entire place because, you know, the wedding's just been taking priority. But I bought some treat bags for... the dessert. I'm just showing stuff that I got. The champagne glasses, candles, her card box, wood sign, the wreaths that I made. And I think I'm gonna order two more from Amazon. That way I can put it on the other shelf. Yeah, that's how it's looking. Okay, we're gonna eat now? Oh, I thought we were gonna cook something. You got that HelloFresh thing. What? You got the HelloFresh that we still have. We'll see. And I think we're gonna end up buying more of these, right?
Like two more, I see.
Maybe two more, I think so. Long ones or short ones?
I see the long ones.
I don't know.
The long ones?
I really like this one. I would like to find another one of this.
You wanna go back over it?
Because I feel like I could put this by the cake table.
You wanna go look for another one today?
Yeah, maybe. Okay. See? Don't lick me. I have tan on. Good morning. It's Saturday. I am actually on my way to pick up. Actually, I'm on my way to meet up this car. What the hell? Oh, it's too early for people not to be driving the correct way. I'm on my way to pick up some candles. I am meeting a former bride that got married at the venue that we're getting married at, and she's giving me some free candles, some candles that she's never used for her wedding, and I get to have them. So, and I don't have to pay for it. She's giving it to me completely free. While I'm waiting for her, let me text her real quick, actually, and tell her that I'm here. So while I'm waiting for her today, there's not much to do today, so I have an appointment with my dress alterations. I actually, last week was actually my final fitting, and I'm picking up my dress today, finally. I then have my eyelash refill appointment, and you guys know the usual. Just go and get that done. And that's it for the rest of the day. I am not doing anything else. I do want to talk about my reception dress real quick. The reviews were incorrect. I followed the reviews and they said to up a size. However, this girl said that she was between a large and an extra large, which is what my size is. And I went through her recommendation of buying two sizes up. So I actually got a 2X and it's way too big on me. So now I have to find an alteration shop to see if they can be able to hem it and to take it in. I could return it, but if I return it, the thing is, I got it on sale. So if I return it, I only get like credit back that I purchased it for. The dress was retailed for $100 and I got it on sale for $30. Now, so if I return it, I only get $30 credit. And the dress is no longer on sale anymore because I got it on Cyber Week and Cyber Week is over. So I will have to pay the remainder. And not only that, but then I risk it coming just before the wedding, and I risk also the chance of it not fitting again, resulting in me having to get it altered again. So I might as well just be stuck with the dress that I have now, the two sizes too big, and just get it altered. I was going to take it with me to my alterations lady. I don't know if I want to. I don't know. She's so far away. I'm here in the Katy area, and I have to drive all the way to Springs, which is by like Conroe and Woodlands. And it's just, she's so far away. So then I will have to go back over there, pick up my dress. And so I might, you know what? Maybe I just answered my own question. Maybe I just won't go, and I'm just rambling. Okay. So these are the candles that I picked up from the girl. They haven't even been used. Even more perfect. So I have a ton of these. I got these from IKEA. I don't know where she got hers from, but there's a difference. Mine's are thinner. And oh my gosh, hers are way thicker. I hope they fit in my vase. Yeah. 2 3/4. I wonder how wide these are. I think my vases are 3 inches across. We'll see. I actually like the garland wrapping around. I didn't like it at first, but Carlos convinced me that it looks good. So I got this on Amazon. So I think I'm gonna go on Amazon and order two more. They come in a two set and it was like $15. So I'm gonna buy two more so I can wrap it on the other one. Yeah. And my wreaths are all still looking pretty good. I don't know why this napkin's here. Yeah, so none of the paint has chipped. Everything's still looking fine. Since I cut these small, they used to look like teardrops and now they look like legit circles because how much I filled it up with the plants and stuff, the greenery. Okay. All right. Real quick, since I'm in a car and I'm halfway in the shade and in light, this is my normal foundation that I've had before, my suntan. Let me know, can somebody let me know if it matches? I don't know, like, I feel like it's okay with my normal foundation. I'm gonna stop sign, so I think it's okay. But I feel like it's okay with my normal foundation. The only difference is I put a lot of bronzer on, a lot. So, but I'm in a shade now, and it looks like my foundation actually matches my spray tan. I don't know. So, somebody tell me. I'm debating if I should still go to the store and buy a foundation that matches my spray tan or stick with my regular foundation and just use a lot of bronzer. I mean, it saves me money on having to buy a $30 bottle of foundation. I know what you're thinking, you're probably thinking, wow, $30 actually, really? But yeah, I like my foundation to be, I like a heavy set of makeup, okay? I like it caked up, so. I'm about to pick up my dress. Oh, that was, I'm pretty done. I have my dress and I don't know what to say. I'm excited. Okay, I'm such a dork, I swear. Okay, bye. Hey, good afternoon. It's Sunday. Let me turn down the AC a bit. Not much is planned today. My only mission today is I found a place nearby. It's an alteration. Some lady that does alterations. I found her on Facebook. And she's gonna actually do my dress. I put it back here in a car. I'm gonna go to Target first and then I'm gonna look for some face products to help me with my acne. I know it's because of stress. I've just been breaking out. I'm not on my cycle right now. I've just been breaking out. So a close up of it is, I don't know why, but it's just on my upper lip area and I can't help but touch my face because I'm picking at it. I'm wearing my Invisaliners if I'm talking with a list. I'm also out of breath. Wow. But yeah, so I'm going to do that. Hopefully I can find some facial or like masks helping me out. I would go to Ulta or Sephora, but I'm on a budget since my bridal's is tomorrow and I'm paying like paying money to get my hair and makeup done. So it was really hard trying to look for a foundation color that goes with my spray tan. I do have a foundation that is too light of my original skin color, so I'll mix that dark foundation with the light foundation and hopefully it'll be a nice balance. I never showed my new veil that I bought from JJ's house. The other veil that I had showed previously in my other vlog was like $13, I think, or $17, I can't remember. But I bought this new bell and it's the opposite, either $13 or $17. I can't remember, but I think I'm gonna go with this one because it's got this white trim all around the edge and it goes perfect with my dress. However, it's not as long as the last veil because I really wanted a cathedral length, but it says it's cathedral length, but it's not as long as the other one. It's gonna go like, I don't know if I'm gonna have my hair up. If it goes up, it'll be like this. I can't see it, sorry. It'll go like right here. Or if I have my hair down, it'll go right above. But that's how it looks like. Get the gist of the length. It's way much lighter than the other length, which I like because the dress is heavy itself and I did want something light on my hair. Real quick, I wanted to show you what I'm doing. I'm actually singing my wedding bells right now and I am prepping for tomorrow's bridal shoot. So I'm gonna wear a face mask to exfoliate my skin, hopefully. These could look better tomorrow. And I'm going to also do a manicure and do these stick-ons that I did last time. I really, really do love these. I couldn't decide which ones I'm going to wear. So the first one, which is the cathedral plain length one, I have it on this side of the bathroom. And on the other one, I have it on the other side. So as you can see, this one is way longer than the other one. And that's not even like folded like I had mentioned it before. But yeah, so I'm just gonna steam them both just in case and then figure out which one I'm gonna wear tomorrow.